Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys an alternative to Magic Mask if you don't have the studio version of Resolve. So on this first node, I ended up using the Magic Mask just to show you one of the benefits. I did one single swipe here. I chose features, clothing top, a single swipe over a shirt. And one of the great things about the Magic Mask, as you can see, when we scroll through, it latches onto a shirt and then nothing else in the shot is being affected. If I toggle this on and off, you can see it's just his shirt and nothing else. So that really makes the Magic Mask an excellent tool. Now for the other version here, you can see he's got now a green shirt. I did that using qualifiers and power windows. So there's a few things you got to do to make this work. Let's go over them right now. I'm going to shut these windows off and we'll get back to those in just a second. Go back over to the qualifier. Now, if we turn this node on and off, you can see anything with the hue that matches his shirt, like this airplane poster and these items on this bookshelf, also get affected by any shifts you make after you've qualified. And if we turn on the highlight, you can see all the items here that are going to be affected. So essentially what we need to do is use power windows to isolate the shirt area of the image. And for something like this, where it's a locked off camera and he doesn't do a whole lot of movement, it works out pretty well. So how we solved that problem was with power windows. First one I used was a gradient window. And if we turn this on and show you the highlight, you can see the gradient essentially takes care of the upper part of the poster and part of the bookshelf. Second part was this circular window, and I put that over the airplane poster. I had this invert on. If you turn on a power window and you don't have that selected, it cuts a hole in your image. But if you have this turned on, it inverts it, so now nothing passes through the window, so it's like a protection zone. And then on the last one, I used a pen tool. So for the pen tool, I just started along here next to his sleeve, came around, went outside the frame and just connected it. And he doesn't really travel too far into that. So there's no softness or anything on this. It's just to isolate that section. So now if I turn the highlight on and off, you don't see it anymore. So we'll turn this back on. Now we have all three. So the gradient's protecting up top, then the circular windows getting the rest of the poster, and the pen tool's getting the shelf. So now we just have his shirt isolated. A little bit right there, but we could probably live without that. Or size this up just a bit more, just right there in the airplane poster. And it holds up pretty well throughout the shot. So now we can adjust the hue of his t-shirt to whatever we feel like, and it does a pretty nice job. So that's how you can isolate clothing or an item without using Magic Mask, using the qualifier and some power windows. All right, thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys on the next one.